Good morning, all. I'm Dr. Alina Ali, third year postgraduate from Osmania Medical College, Hyderabad. I'm hereby presenting my paper on cross-sectional imaging in blunt renal trauma, a prospective study. The study was done under the guidance of Dr. Nadeem Muhammad and Dr. Vijay Kumari, professors of Osmania Medical College, Hyderabad. Renal injury is third most common solid organ injury in blunt abdominal trauma, accounting for 14.1 cases of abdominal injuries, in which blunt trauma accounts for up to 70%. CT is the method of choice for blunt renal injuries. Contrast enhanced CT is readily available in emergency department and can quickly and accurately depict renal injuries as well as associated injuries to other abdominal or retroperitoneal organs. The AST grading system is a widely used classification based on surgical findings and shows good correlation both with CT findings and prognosis. Aims and objectives: to show wide spectrum of computer tomography findings in blunt renal trauma, describe and illustrate imaging features of range of AST injury grades of renal trauma. Materials and methods: study design and place of study, hospital-based observational prospective study conducted in Department of Radiodiagnosis at a tertiary care hospital. Study period, 24 months starting from October 2019. Study subjects, patient with history of blunt abdominal trauma referred for CECT abdomen. Patient with CECT features of renal injury included in the study, and unstable patients, patients with other solid organ injuries, bowel injuries, mesenteric injuries, and patients of age less than 18 years, patient with a history of penetrating trauma were excluded from the study. Patients suspected of having blunt abdominal trauma coming to emergency department undergo ultrasound abdomen followed by contrast enhanced CT. The CT was performed in 128-slice multi-detector CT Hitachi Scenaria. After injection of non-ionic contrast, Omnipaque 300 ml per kilogram at 3 ml per seconds, CT acquisition performed in late arterial phase and in the portal venous phase. Delayed scanning done in cases of higher grade of injury. A total of 93 patients were evaluated, in which 20 patients showed CECT features of renal injury. Every study was reviewed for identification of renal injuries, and injuries were graded according to 2018 AST renal injury scale. A statistical analysis was performed with frequency and percentages variables. Observation: out of 20 patients with renal injuries, majority of are male, accounting for 85%, and 3 females and 70 males were included in the study, of age ranging from 20 to 60 years. Majority of the patients of age 30 to 40 years. 8 patients are grade 1 injury, of which CECT showed renal condition of subcapsular hematoma. 4 patients had grade 2 injury, of which renal laceration of less than 10 mm detected in CT. 3 patients had grade 3 injury with CECT showed laceration of more than 10 mm. 3 patients showed grade 4 injury, of which 2 patients showed parenchymal laceration extended into renal hilum with urinary extravasation in delayed scan. 1 patient with grade 4 injury showed deep parenchymal laceration extending into renal pelvis, causing segmental infarction of the kidney. 2 patients had grade 5 injury with CECT features of complete devascularization of the kidney. 70 patients had associated hemoperitoneum, 3 patients had splenic injury, and 6 patients had liver injury, and 3 patients had associated fractures like pelvic fractures, vertebral fractures, and rib fractures. Majority of the injuries were of grade 1, accounting for 40% of the cases. These are some representative images from my study. First image, 30-year-old male patient with a history of road traffic accident. Axial contrast enhanced CT showing hypodensity noted involving upper pole. Second case, 35-year-old male patient with a history of fall. Axial contrast enhanced CT showing subcapsular hematoma. These are grade 1 injuries. Next case is 33-year-old female patient with a history of road traffic accident. Axial contrast enhanced CT showing laceration of less than 10 mm. With the perirenal hematoma. This is a case of grade 2 injury. Next case is 40-year-old male patient with a history of road traffic accident. Axial contrast enhanced CT showing laceration extending into the renal, into the collecting system. This is a case of grade 3 injury. Next case is 28-year-old male patient with a history of RTA. Axial contrast enhanced CT showing hematoma extending beyond the gerota fascia. On delayed scanning, urinary extravasation was noted. This case is a coronal contrast enhanced CT of CT showing hypodensity involving mid and lower pole of kidney, suggesting segmental infarction. These two are cases of grade 4 injury. Next case is 40-year-old male patient with a history of RTA, coronal contrast enhanced CT showing complete devascularization of the left kidney, suggesting grade 5 injury. Renal injuries are classified into 5 grades of severity according to the American Association of Surgeons in Trauma Injury Severity Scale. Grade 1 is subcapsular hematoma and or parenchymal condition without laceration. Grade 2 is perirenal hematoma confined to aorta fascia. Renal parenchymal laceration less than or equal to 1 cm depth without urinary extravasation. Grade 3 is renal parenchymal laceration more than 1 cm in depth without collecting system rupture or urinary extravasation. Any injury in the presence of kidney vascular injury or active bleeding contained within the aorta fascia also included. Grade 4 is parenchymal laceration extending into urinary collecting system with the urinary extravasation, renal pelvis laceration and or complete uretropelvic disruption, segmental renal vein or artery injury, active bleeding beyond aorta fascia into the retroperitoneum or peritoneum, segmental or complete kidney infarction due to vessel thrombosis with active bleeding. Grade 5 is main renal artery or vein laceration or avulsion of hilum. Devascularized kidney with active bleeding, shattered kidney with loss of identified parenchymal renal anatomy. All cases in the study with one blunt renal injuries are classified based on American Association of Surgery of Trauma. This classification enables standardization of various renal trauma and a choice of proper therapy and prediction. Majority of renal injuries detected were minor injuries like contusion, minor parenchymal laceration, which were amenable to non-operative management. Deep parenchymal laceration and urinary extravasation can also be treated conservatively. A delay scan can be used in patient with the renal damage degree to determine whether the cholecystic system is damaged or not. In our study, damage to renal pelvis were noted in 3 patients. Conclusion: MDCT can generate wide spectrum of findings in renal trauma, and majority of these can be easily categorized into 5 AST grades. The AST classification must be kept in mind when reporting renal injuries. We concluded that enhanced MDCT scan permits reliable detection of renal trauma and the associated organ or tissue injuries, providing important clinical value for the diagnosis and classification of renal trauma or internal organ injuries. These are my references. Thank you.